Hello, and welcome. I'm Zeinder, and oh, it appears all this stuff is finished. Wait a second. Okay, yes. So, there's some things I want to do. First of all, I made an electromagnet because I was sick of dealing with things. Pulls nearby items towards you. Shift right-click to enable slash disable, and it has to be in the hotbar. Now, it does take power, but because I'm within range of the wireless charger, it's not emptying. It's something like 1 RF per second or something like that, so it's not a big deal. I put lead exosuit plates in my armor, and also some ink sacs, because the blue and yellow looked odd, although now I have this. I made another exosuit, but I found out that it doesn't work with cosmetic armor for some reason, so that's kind of annoying. And I put an extendo fist in, which increases my range. I put in thrusters, which increase my flight speed, and I think that's it. Yes. So with the full knockback, I basically don't take knockback. So yeah. I've got all the resources set up here. I made a couple extra things. Well, not quite. I think I actually stopped before I got there. So, we need blueprints, which is paper around a thing. Yeah, a thing. And over here in the workbench, diamond gears. It basically looks exactly like other recipes we've done, but this will get the architect table. And what this is for will become apparent soon enough. Okay, so, iron transport pipes, block placers, teleposer, transport conduits. I made another set. Diamond gear, obsidian, that. That's most of the everything I need. Now I just need to take this, and this. Yeah. And that'll get us an integration table. So, this requires the lasers, so we'll place it here. And this is actually going to take a long time to do. The reason why I say this is because of these. Wait. Do I have enough? Oh, I already made gates. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So, you put the pulsating chipsets there. Oh, I didn't pull out the gates. The gates are really simple. The wires are made from an ingot, redstone, and the given color. Basic gates only support red. You can see compatible wires red. And it's made from a redstone chipset and a red pipe wire. So, this will actually take a little while because it's 100,000 a piece. But this will create an Octarctic Pulsar. I'm curious as to whether or not I can put quartz chipsets in, which are nether quartz and redstone. These allow you to put a clock timer on. And here's the iron chipset, by the way. The higher tier you get, the more wire colors you need, because the more wire colors they support. I did this because I needed support for two wire colors, because my test design, I have plans to alter it. Because I had tested this to make sure that Remain in Motion wouldn't crash it. But oh, and I've got another thing in my inventory here. It's the gate copier. It is a redstone chipset and a buildcraft wrench, which is a stone gear or basic gear and 3 iron ingots. It's used for copying gate settings, which is going to drastically speed up this process. Nope. And we're going to go down here. The question is, where do I start? That's there. This is that. Where is the gigantic hole I made? I forget. Oh, it's this one. So we can go this way in relative peace. So what I'm going to do is I want to clear out a 5x5, well, I might want to make it slightly, no, I can work around that. So as you can see, the electromagnet's making it really simple for me to just mine this out and not have to worry about picking up the blocks, which is extremely convenient. But I need a 5x5 space. Once I get everything set up, clearing these out, if I go to move it, will be incredibly simple. And I'll show you what I mean by that in, well, sort of a second. Well, I don't have the machine required to do that necessarily, but if we ever have to move it, which we will, the plan is to actually make it so I can easily move it, and I'll show you what I mean by that. But first of all, this needs to be 5. Now, I'm assuming, because I haven't actually tested this, that with the template carriage thing, I should be able to click on any block and then it will collapse into that. I actually didn't need to do the very back. I'll put this here. Okay, so. Oops. Oh, and as for the ones that didn't stack, all I had to do was place them down and then break them with my axe, and it resolved that issue. In case you were wondering. Okay, so, 5 high? Yes, I did make this the right height. That'll simplify matters slightly. I wouldn't say the magnet's 100% reliable, but it's still considerably better than trying to pick it up myself. So I should have about 3 of these left over when I'm done. Now, the only thing is I need to do a slight think on how I'm going to do this. It would need to be, let's see, pipe space thing. So I would have to condense it to roughly here. Huh, very good. Can I unexpand you? Well, I'll have to set it up manually next time. Because I've technically made a slight mistake in this regard. So, what I am going to want to do, though, is here. Oops. Put them up here. Oops. Whoops. Okay, so these will go here. Then, which, I'll put them on this side for simplicity's sake. So I'm going to put this here, and just to make sure that no issues happen. Oh, no. This is in the wrong spot. Give me that. I need to put down the iron pipes first. These are to make sure that I don't end up with any weird issues, like it trying to, say, place the blocks again out the other side and end up in a sort of like breaking loop. So the clear side on these is where items are going to go. So in this case, I'm going to want the items to end up approximately. I did not allocate for this quite 100%. I was gonna use two teleposers to speed up the process, but that's not gonna work unless I have like two sets of my little system going on here, and that's a terrible, terrible idea. So, that said, now that I've got these in place, this will go here, this will go here, and this will go here to make sure that's facing the right direction. Then on top of that, we'll place this. This should be facing out. Now it's a block placer. Oh, this is why I brought this. That will go there. And I'm actually missing one thing I wanted to make, but I can live with that. So then I'm going to need the locker here, I think. Because then the teleposer will be here. If that's magenta, that means that this side is green. Let's break this. Yes. Yes, that is green. Okay, so you're going to go in on green, out on magenta, and I'm just going to put in the word quarry. And I'm gonna put in a specification on those to make sure that nothing will actually come in, if that makes any sense. Because I don't want it to feed anything back, just in case. And I suppose I brought too many lockers, but it'll be okay. So I should be able to place these in here. Now if I clear out a slight space around here, and I'll start by putting... actually, give me some of these. Start out by putting one of these here. And I'll put this here. And I'll put the transpressurizer down here. Although I don't have any way to supply power at this exact second. As you can see, this is slowly draining. And this is actually a majority of the setup. I say majority because it's obviously not 100%, but, right. I don't have all the gates at the moment. I want to, if that's going to go there, the only problem is there's a slight bug with, I'm actually going to take this, partly because it's the wrong spot anyhow. There's a slight bug with how the buildcraft pipes function with this, so I think what I'm going to do, you know what, I'll do it like that, because that's fine, that works. Okay, you go there, so you're going that way, you're going that way, I guess we'll feed them all towards the middle. Oops. 3, 1, 2, right, so, 1, 2, 2. 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Are you feeding down? You're feeding down. And you're feeding down. And you're feeding down, and you're feeding down. Okay. So then I'll feed them all into the middle. Doing it this way should also hopefully cause things to reach their destination slightly quicker. Because they're only going half as far as in my test design. Speaking of the test design, I should probably stability check what I'm planning on doing here. Can I do this any better? If I had another iron pipe instead. No. Well, maybe. What if I put that directly there? It's too late. I say it's too late because I said so. So I believe this is everything that I can place down right now. I don't actually want to place the landmarkers yet. How do I get out? I suppose the easiest way is to fly up. Right here. Whoops. All those crates and stuff are still sitting there. I haven't pulled them out and done anything with them yet. So, the question is, how many of these gates have finished? Because I'm going to need at least 2. I've got 10. This is good. I approve. Let's see. So I've got 10. That'll have to do for now. That'll be enough to really get it showing what I'm planning on doing. Go away, things. Okay, so... down. Whee! Where did I put you? I put you here. Put a torch as a reference marker. So, I'm gonna put one of these here. And this is going to be permanently on. As you can see, it breaks the block, which is perfect. If I break this, it placed it because it keeps its power. So I might actually need to put any power into that because it should stock it for a while, but I'll probably eventually do that anyhow. So that is in there. Oh, I didn't bring the other thing I was gonna do. Now, I'm gonna put a. Oops. I'm gonna actually do these with a red pipe signal, which is why there's a bunch of red pipe wire up there that I completely forgot about. Oh, like, okay, I need red pipe in order to start that configuration. Crap. Feels like my modular accelerator's not working. Why are you not working, modular accelerator? Oh well. I should probably just take it for what it is. What if I take it off and put it back on? Nope. No difference. Okay, so I made a lot of red pipe wire. And I'm actually gonna need the blue pipe wire, and I might as well grab these gates. So the one side one, the one sticking off to the side, creating that hole for the infinitude pipes, that one's going to be always running because there's no reason for it to turn off. It's gonna be used for both parts of my plan, if that makes any sense. But I'd like to turn off the other ones because I don't know about gates and their effect on performance. But I do believe that that is one of the things that the developers of BuildCraft test, is to see how much of an impact running hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of things have on performance. Right, I do need to put it on the iron pipes. I thought I might. Because the stripes pipes do not directly connect to each other, I need to put it on the iron pipes. As well. Right? Is that all of them? Let's check. Did I miss any? Does not look like it. Okay. So, we're gonna open up this gate, we're gonna set it to red pipe signal on, energy pulsar. Now, we're gonna take our gate copier, we're going to right click, and then we're going to shift right click on every other gate that I put down on the front of this. And, oops, it has to be an Octarctic pulsar in order to be able to supply the power so it can actually tell things to do stuff like how that is. So that one's gonna keep running. I need to get the rest of the gates on here, and I might cease the process of making those so I can make the other two items that I wish to make. I think. That's kind of the plan. I wish my modular accelerator was working right now. Okay, so I'm actually gonna take out this and these. Excuse me, but once you've finished with your nonsense here, I'd like you to do these. Is this also 100,000? It is. So this is gonna take a short little while. Because I want to make this thing not only detect. I want it to detect when it's finished and stop running things. The finished is literally going to be determined solely and completely by whether or not there are pipes in the block placer. Now, I need these, which will add a clock timer to it. And I can run these off the pipe signal. And they should also be able to put out a redstone signal so And based on what I was able to understand, the clock pulsar, the clock timer rather, that's not pulsar. The clock timer is a trigger event. So I needed iron gates because I'm going to use see, I only need wait. No. I actually need you on a regular gate. I might have I don't know if I'm gonna have enough regular gates if I'm doing this. This one needs to be this, but the other one only needs to be able to detect red. And only needs to send red. So the other iron gate doesn't actually need anything on it, if that makes any sense. Do I need structure pipe? I'm probably gonna need structure pipe. Do I have gravel? Like, readily available? There's probably. Actually, there might not be any gravel down there because I'm pretty sure. Ah, crap. I think I used all the gravel. You know what? That's gonna make graphite, but I don't really care. You know what? You can make some bricks. I don't even care. I just need some empty inventory at this point. Pork chop. Okay. So I distracted myself. I need cobblestone. You know what? I keep forgetting that I have those down there. And apparently I already had some cobblestone. I don't have any gravel as far as I can tell. But I can make structure pipe. That's not an issue. You're done. Very good. I will give you your pulsars back. See, I need 28. I may have to make another gate. Although the idea is to get the core concept of what I'm doing going here, but then again, I also want to use the architect table. Although, I guess the use of it won't really show until later, to be honest. Okay, so you are more pulsar gates. I'll put you here, here, here. And I don't remember if I did that, but I did it anyhow, because why not? So this is the clock timer. And we're going to put the carriage here. Okay? So. What am I doing again? Right. I need structure pipe, which means I need gravel. Which means I need to kind of look for some gravel. Let's go up here and check this. Oh, there's some gravel. But let's see if there's any in here. No, no, no. I took the electromagnet off my bar and that caused bad things. Okay. Oops, I actually need to be down here. The heck was that noise? Okay, structure pipe. This is as it sounds. It's basically just a pipe that is a structure. If that makes like any sense at all. So I want this to be able to go both ways, so I need it on both sides, like so. Why did that connect to that though? That's not supposed to happen. Okay, so you're the regular iron gate. Does that need to that? I think I might have done this with one gate more than I really needed, to be honest. And I'm gonna actually need an extra gate that's not a pulsar, but the idea is that I'll put this guy here. And I'll put this guy here. Then I will run a red pipe signal, which I just realized I kind of wanted the red pipe signal to be kind of connective between these. Oh, that's convenient. Okay, I'm gonna hope that I can just put a gate right there. Actually, well, yeah, I'm gonna need that there because I need to make sure that jumps over. But then that should go there. Okay. I'm gonna put blue pipe signal on. And it looks like our options are 5, 10, or 15 second timers. So, this should not run because there is no blue pipe signal. So, if there is inventory empty, blue pipe signal. I can actually do this with this, can't I? No, because it's an AND gate, so both conditions would have to be true in order to trigger a signal. Crap. I actually don't want this thing to move just yet. No, you needed to be an AND gate, or an iron gate. So I actually need to make... I need to make another iron gate that needs to be a clock timer. This guy's actually kind of useless. Unless... No, because that's a clock timer, so that defeats the purpose. Crap. Okay, I made a mistake. This one's useless in this case. So... The idea is that I'm basically going to have one of these on each side. It will output a redstone signal if it has a blue pipe signal. And I'm not going to be able to finish this right away, unfortunately. But I will use this to show you how this works. So I'm going to place this here. Actually, I'm going to do this on the other side because I dug it high enough. So, thankfully, these are not running because there's no red pipe signal. So that makes this possible. So now we've got a square. A square that consists of the entirety of our structure here, despite the fact that it's unfinished. But this is to give you an idea on how the architect table functions. If I put it there, I'm not going to be able to walk anywhere. Now, if I place this down, it knocks out the things and puts down this little blue and black line. So if in here I call it, I'm going to call it the tunnel bore because that's effectively what it is, but I'm going to have to copy over this blueprint. So then what I can do is, conveniently, it'll also save the gate data, and it should save the wires being on there. It saves, I know for a fact, the iron pipe configuration, and I'm assuming it also saves the pipe plug configuration if it saves all the rest of that. So I have a schematic of this. Now you can overwrite very simply by just putting it back in. So this is effectively useless at the moment, though, because this isn't finished. But then what I can do is later on I can use either a builder or builder robots to reconstruct it. So I can tear it down and reconstruct it without needing to do all the gate data, without needing to wrench all the iron pipes and all that. The reason why I have two templates is because I actually wanted to make one of the template, the frame carriage system. But I can make that later. I'm not worried about that. That's really simple. There's nothing difficult about it. Why did that give me that? So, that's pretty much the full complete idea The only problem now is that I'm going to be short on gates. If I make a quartz chipset, so I need a piece of quartz and a piece of redstone. If I make a quartz chipset, I can take that iron and gate, repurpose the quartz chipset onto that, and then all I have to do is make a regular iron gate, but this time I would make an ore gate. And then I should be able to actually set that up. So this should make both of these. It'll take a little while, it'll take 600,000 RF for the thing here. This clock timer is effectively useless. I wonder if I can install a pulsar on it. Oh. I mean, it's a bit of a waste, but it works. I'll take it, because it's better than nothing. That's not going to continue, is it? Oh. The machine will not be finished till I have both of these. So, for the last thing we're going to do, I'm going to take 4 iron, 8 redstone, 4 copper. Actually, I think I need another redstone block, possibly. Nope. Well, I'm gonna have extra redstone, probably. And I'm going to need gold nuggets. Whoops. Because there's actually a lesser version of the capacitor now, which is what I'm going to put on there. Because you can see they depreciated it in order to make the other one. And this is the one that I have. But there's also a basic capacitor bank, which is considerably cheaper. So there's no more needing to deal with super expensive capacitor banks. If you just need some early storage. Okay, so I have all the red pipe wire and blue pipe wire I need, I think. So I've already done those. I have the extra redstone that I'll put in there. And it is conveniently charging this out of my inventory. The only problem now is I need more gates finished. But what is my plan? That is a question. I am going to go back over here, put these gates in, paste this gate information onto them. I'm assuming the basic gate, which has the clock timer and the pulsar, should work just fine with the gate copier, because it should still support the settings I'm going to be giving it, in theory. I'll have you know that a magnet is not a gate. Dune, 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 dune. So, I do in fact need 3 more gates. I don't know where I started, so we'll just paste onto this whole third one. No gate found on the side. I thought I would see what would happen. Now I know. I need 3 more gates, and we're already getting higher than I want to in terms of time, but what are you gonna do? If I put this here, does it default to output? It does. Are you draining? Not really. And I don't have an inventory here. I'll probably put a stack of crates. Kind of like this, but not quite. I'm curious. Will it condense down automatically if I just start breaking crates? Huh. Good. Perfect. I'll take it. Right, so the only downside to this is that I don't really have enough room. That should be more than enough space. Whoops. Go. Go. I don't know why it does that. Like, it seems to have weird shape requirements. Okay. I actually don't want you here. I'd prefer you be here. Good. It hooked up, as I had hoped. So, we want in on green. Oh, it crashed. Why did this happen? Well, it crashed. What? Can't be called client side. Oh. Wait, I don't know. I'm gonna call this good. I'll probably show you the rest of it next time, but I'm going to finish it in between. But I'm going to call this good for now, and I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day.